Medardo Rosso, The Concierge, 1883. Medardo Rosso lived in Via Montebello in Milan, where the concierge, sure a Mrs. Ursula, was a constant presence, someone he met several times a day, and who became one of his favorite subjects. In fact, he dedicated more than 12 portraits to her. Medardo employs very clear walks and uses his fingertips to give shapes to his statues. Like the Impressionists, he wants to represent real images, where light is the dominant feature. And what the Impressionist painters do with their style, based on spots of color, he does with sculpture. His works, artworks, are only outlined and are supposed to be seen from a definite point of view. Medardo, a rebel and anarchist, displayed one of these portraits even a sacred art exhibition in Venice, using the same art piece but with a different name. The concierge was then introduced to the visitors at St. Ursula.
Medardo Rosso, The Church, Sexton, Scaccino, 1883. Medardo is very modern and old at the same time. Regarded as similar to the Impressionists, he uses Michelangelo's technique of the unfinished, but quickly, with a touch of light, using strange materials, wax, bronze, earth, any material. He often sculpts faces, parts of faces, as his art pieces are often unfinished in their back, because they are not intended to be observed at 360 degrees. He is inspired by photographs considered as images rather than as round sculptures, which he regards as works of art. Medardo, an anarchist and anti-clerical, represents here a drunk sexton, inspired by the sacristan of the Church of San Marco, whom the artist must have known. He has a big nose and his sleepy face is leaning downwards. That's how he sees and represents him, someone who does nothing but drinking. He chose to first display the statue in a ridiculous way. He put it on the red marble font of holy water, with the label, Plenary Indulgence, and to the title of the statue he added the sentence, I wish you were grappa.
Medardo Rosso, bookmaker, 1902. This is the bronze portrait of Eugene Marin, a horse racing fan. He is wearing a top hat, and in his hands is carrying binoculars and cane. But he is not a bookmaker. That mistake is probably due to the first translation, made by an art critic who wanted to stress the undeniably disturbing appearance of the statue. The figure is diagonally tilted and has photographic style, even though it is not a two-dimensional image. The dark coat that wraps the body makes the sculpture a single mass, where the face is just outline. The man almost merges with the space outside. He is a frightening character and one who has probably inspired many of those classic figures that in horror film come out of the fog.